Hello, folks. My name is Jordi for CineCam.net, and welcome to Copycat Friday, a weekly series where we recreate an effect from a film or music video. And today we are having a look at Solo from Clean Bandit and Demi Lovato. Now, let's not talk about the story of the song, but just let's have a look at the cool face going up in smoke effect. Everything you saw in the intro was completely self-made, even the smoke. So first up, guys, we're going to recreate the laboratory scene where Jannik over here is going to cook something, I'm going to eat that, and then my face is going to explode.
It's a slider.
The only thing that you're going to need is a shot of yourself. Just make sure that nothing comes in front of your face. When you're going to work in Premiere Pro, I suggest you film this from a tripod and make sure that you keep your head as still as possible. If you're familiar with After Effects, you can go handheld and move around. We'll also show you by the end of the video how that works. Next up, you can remove everything from your set as we're going to film a smoke torch. It has to be white smoke, and you want to make sure that your camera angle is somehow the same. So if you filmed your subject a little from above, so should that angle be on the smoke. And since we want to use the smoke and not the background of your shot, make sure that it is completely dark, so hanging a black fabric in the background is really important. Now, the smoke has to be thick, which is why we didn't use a smoke machine. You can also find stock clips of smoke, like on video blocks. And we actually came across this clip right here, which will work very good. And if you're not familiar yet with video blocks, well, it's a huge library where you can always find something to help you out on your next video project. And interesting is that you only have to pay one price, and with that you can download unlimited items. You can check the first link in the description below to learn more, and I'll also add a direct link to that smoke clip in it. Now, we are going to film the smoke ourselves, as that also allows us to match the lighting. And this is definitely important if you have a scene with colored lighting, like we have. If you're shooting this outside or working with natural lighting, then a stock clip will blend perfectly as well.
Test one.
Oh shit, the smoke alarm! I totally forgot about the smoke alarm! Just in time.
And now it's time to bring your two shots into Premiere Pro. Your normal shot can already go to the bottom of your timeline. On top of that goes the smoke clip. Now, we can't blend the smoke with our clip, as that will make it transparent. You want to retain that thick smoke, so here's what we're going to do. Just duplicate the smoke clip to the layer above. We're going to use one of these smoke clips as a mask, and in order to do that, I search for the track matte effect in the library and drag that to the bottom smoke layer. Target layer number 3, which is the duplicate smoke layer, as we want to use that for the matte. And then change the composite to matte luma. Now, if your matte doesn't look right, you can use Lumetri to change its contrast and exposure. If you notice having a dark edge around your matte, you can decrease the shadows to remove that. And if you're still having trouble with the edge, you can nest the two clips together and apply a roughen edges effect to it. And this way you can bite a bit into the edge of the smoke or feather it. If you don't need to do this, then you can nest the two layers together anyways. You can then go ahead and reposition this group to your subject's face. Then under the opacity property, click on the pen tool to draw a mask around the face so that it obviously seems like your face goes up into smoke. And you might also want to feather this mask a tiny bit. Then with that layer selected, head over to Lumetri, where I'm going to match the colors of the smoke to the skin tones. And you can use the color wheels for that. Remember to also add enough contrast to the smoke, as it's probably going to be too flat. Also, the saturation is something that you want to decrease. Skin tones are not as saturated as other common colors. And this brings us to the final step. Create a new color mat and place it underneath the smoke clip. You can also disable the output of that smoke clip for a second. Then draw a mask on that color mat around your face. Search for the 4 color gradient in your effects library and bring that to the solid. With the color picker, I'm taking samples of the color of my face in each corner. This gives you a color gradient of the skin tones, which is more natural than just having one solid color. Now you can go ahead and enable the smoke layer back. Now, if you have moved your camera or your head, we're going to have to track that motion inside After Effects. The entire process works exactly the same, except for the track matte effect, which is in After Effects a default property. You can just change your bottom smoke clip to track matte luma, and that's it. As for retracking, you want to select your normal clip and head over to the tracker window. Enable position and scale, which will give you 2 tracking points. Position them on a visual point in your face, for example, on the eye and the other one to the nose. Hit the track play button to let it analyze the motion. Then create a new layer from the menu on top and choose null object. From your tracker window, you want to click on edit target and choose that null object layer. Then hit apply and click OK. The null object should now have the tracking data. The only thing left to do is to use the whip tool in your layers and connect it to that null object. I'm doing this for both the smoke clip and the color mat, which removed my face. And that is how you can blow up your face. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you Videoblocks for your support. And by the way, guys, if you would like to see some more behind the scenes of what we're doing here at Cinecom, then make sure to follow us on Instagram. There's a link in the description below. But most importantly, stay creative.
Hey guys, we're currently here outside because we are shooting for our brand new course for Adobe After Effects, which is coming very soon. And you know what? The sun is shining pretty hard, so Lorenzo can't see what's happening on his monitor, and that's why he's wearing this bag over his head. But you know what? If it looks silly and it works, it ain't stupid.